Everybody take a nice deep cleansing breath. My grandson goes, he growls. He growl talks. It's pretty simple. It's hilarious. I'm going to go anyway. Is it time?
Yeah, just a minute more. We're almost there. I know it's exciting.
Ready to go.
It's officially 2 o'clock.
Hey, everybody. How y'all doing out there? It's fall. Leaves are falling everywhere, but it's beautiful outside. 2020 pretty much sucked, though, didn't it? Yeah. I thought this was going to be a great year with that 2020. You would think, you know, everything would be great, but whoa, man, it's not. But I didn't get to do my 9/11 show last week, so I'm doing it today because I remember 9/11 so well. And I remember 9/11. I was awakened. One of my kids came in and said, Daddy, you got to look on the TV. And I did. And I thought, I kept waiting for King Kong to swing around the building, you know, but it didn't happen, man. It was one of the saddest, the saddest day in history. It really was. And that was terrible. A lot of terrible things going on, but a lot of good things going on too. But even one more thing. This is the 50th anniversary of the death of the great Jimi Hendrix. Wow, what would he be like now? What would he and Clapton be doing? They'd be best buddies. Clapton told me he lost a good friend and a sounding board and somebody to duel with. You know, he said, I didn't know what to do for a long time after he was gone, but Eric got it back. He's okay. Thank you. A New Day medley that's got a few tunes in it there, and it's sad, then it's fast, then it's sad, and it's been a sad time for me over the past couple of weeks. I had a really good friend that I lost out in Austin, Texas last week, a friend of mine, Tom Middleton. A lot of you, especially in the Austin area, would have known Tom. Great guy. Dobro, man, he helped build the RQ Jones Dobro that I played with the Whites and some with Allison. I mean, I played the guitar a long time before I played Tim Shearhorn's guitars, which, you know, it was hard to go from one, my old Dobro, to the Jones, to the Shearhorn, and then to the Beard. But, you know, you love them all. And that Dobro, though, was on more country records than I think any Dobro's probably ever been on. And it's out in the Museum of the Musical Instrument Museum in Scottsdale, Arizona, which is a wonderful place to go. You should go there. But anyway, back to Tom. Tom was one of these guys who we smoked cigars together. Every time I went to Texas, he'd show me around. He took me and Barry Bales and a bunch of us to a little place in North Austin, a little dive bar called Jenny's Little Longhorn Lounge. And I posted a thing earlier this week about a thing they used to do at the Longhorn Lounge there called Chicken Shit Bingo. And Tom turned me on to so many cool things, but the Chicken Shit Bingo thing was they'd open the door and a chicken would walk in, and everybody would buy spaces on this grid. They'd make up a big grid. And the chicken would walk in, and the chicken would walk over onto the grid, and wherever the chicken did its business was, if it hit your spot, you won all the money. It's the greatest thing. I think we should have that everywhere. In fact, I'm thinking about getting some chickens. Yeah. But Tom, man, I lost a great friend. We all did. And say along, Tom. Cousin Marco's been there taking care of everything, and another friend, Kim, went in and took care of all the instruments. Tom had a lot of instruments, and they're going to be out there on the market now. But he had Black Beards, he had Old Dough Rose, he had a lot of Resophonic guitars, but he had a lot of Martins and a lot of Strats and Tellys and everything. Had a lot of these old guitars that cowboy stars, you know, you would paint your, they paint things on these guitars and little kids would be playing them. I know I had one of them, probably fell on it at some point. I don't think it's around anymore, but you know, that was a hard week. That was a hard week. Just Tom had just retired a month ago, and he had a problem with things in the nightshade family, vegetables in the nightshade family. You got to watch out for it. Is it tomatoes, avocados, a lot of things that you just in the, it's called the nightshade family, but he developed an allergy to that and it did him in. He was retired, and he was 3 weeks into his retirement, he died, and it's a very sad thing. Gonna miss him. Oh wow. Thanks to Steve and Patty out there for helping me along with that. And they were good friends of his, and man, God bless y'all. And it's been a tough one. It's been a tough one. Where did Miss Barbara go? Hey, Miss Barbara. Hey, wake up, Miss Barbara. I started this. I bit this coat hanger, but there was this Miss Barbara. You guys will have to explain to the new folks who Miss Barbara is, because I'm not going to do it. But Miss Barbara sees Steve and Polly, sees Marco, sees my friend Paige Neely, who has been one of the best friends to my daughters, and she's the sweetest girl, has the most going on. She is just so smart, so intelligent. But I won't tell all the secrets that I said I was going to tell on her today, but happy birthday to Paige. And love all you other people, my kids, my little kids, Millie and Theo and Wyatt. And, you know, it's just great having these little kids around now. It's wonderful. And it's like having my own back again, but I can send these home when it's all over and load them up with chocolate and send them home. That's what you do. Let's see. Did I miss anybody? I think that's it. You probably want me to play. I want me to play, folks. It's nice to play. I went and hung out with my friend Russ Barenberg yesterday. He told me to just shut up and play. But here's a song that I wrote a long time ago and was on an Alison Krauss record. Not sure what year this was or what record this was on, but it's called The Choctaw Hayride. And my friend Tommy Emmanuel really loves to play this one. And the last time Tommy and I played this was on stage, but we did one of these Facebook Live things from Milan, Italy, and we played this song there. And hello Tommy, let's play together real soon. Come on, man. Actually, he gave me some socks. They were just delivered to me. I hope you can see this. It's a ringmaster of the shit show. Thank you, Tommy. All right. The music business is no fun. See, here it is. Yeah. Myself than I thought. Are we okay? Everybody all right? I'm gonna try something a little different here. This is a song called Little Maggie. But I don't want to play it in the regular time. Song. It's not a whole lot to it, but it's a beautiful song, and there are lots of ways to play it, but I'd never played it that way before, so I thought I would try. Thanks for listening. Had to do that. Sorry. Couple of advertisements here. I'm going to do my first live gig coming up. with my band, with kind of the acoustic band, with the Mike Seal and Christian Settlemeyer and Daniel. And we're gonna play at the City Winery, at what they're calling the City Winery, the Garden, here in Nashville, Tennessee, on October the 11th. And it's only for about 125 people, I think, something like that. And it's spaced well. It's done very well. My friend John Hyatt just did it, said he enjoyed it so much because he got to play live and everyone got to hear live music. So win-win, right? Everybody stayed safe. Everything went well. And Keb Mo did one as well, I know. And it's just a lot of fun to play to real people. And we haven't gotten to do that since March, you know, believe it or not. Isn't that crazy? You haven't heard any live music since March. It's a crazy, crazy world. One thing I forgot to mention was the fires out in the West. God bless you folks out there hanging on. I talked to a fellow up in the Bay Area yesterday who said that they had a kind of a nice day yesterday. The smoke had gone away for the day, but it was coming back today. Wow. It's just a crazy, crazy situation we got going on in this world, but it can only get better, can it? And it will. I think it will. I'm going to play with Blackberry Smoke on a live stream from the Ryman on the 23rd of September. That's going to be fun, playing in the Ryman. I did a thing there, a taping thing there for the IBMA's virtual festival this year. I did a thing with a whole bunch of banjo players, believe it or not, which was a blast. And tomorrow I get to talk with J.D. Crowe and Winston Marshall, who plays banjo with Mumford and Sons. I get to talk to them tomorrow, and I think that's going to be part of the IBMA weekend as well. Just those two, the meeting of the minds, the meeting of the worlds. You know, one guy bringing rock and roll from bluegrass to rock and roll, and the other one playing from rock and roll toward bluegrass. It's going to be a one, and I'm the moderator, so I'll be the interpreter for both of them, from Kentucky to London. It's going to be so good. I can't wait to do it. But Blackberry Smoke live stream. Charlie Starr on all of Blackberry Smoke. Charlie's a wonderful guy. You know, they're a great band. Just a beautiful, what a great rock and roll band. And I'm looking forward to that. You know, things are lightening up in the musical world just a little bit, but it's tough out there for people. It's so tough. And that's why we've got the IBMA trust fund button. I hope you can see that. I hope we did it right today. And please dig deep for those people. Dig way down in your trouser pockets, as Mr. Sean Camp says with the Earls of Leicester. So one more song. And I'll leave you with this one. This has been fun today, folks. Sorry I wasn't around last week. I was visiting my folks, helping them finish up their garden. And I was there for the last of the tomatoes and the grinding up tomato juice, making tomato juice with my mom and dad. And wonderful, just wonderful. So here's the song. This is Both Sides Now, and I'll do this one and leave you with this. See you next Friday. That will be after end of September the 23rd is my son Grant's birthday. So happy birthday to everybody out there. My friend Paige, Paho, happy birthday. Grant, I'll see you in just a few days. Thank you. next week.